May 2013. Welcome to the month's news from Angling Lines. In this month's special, episode 5 of our Living the Dream series. First, updates and fishing news from the month. Jontree 7 is now available through Angling Lines. It's a 5-acre lake available exclusively for two anglers. Owned and run by fish farmer Paul Bachelier, it's no surprise it's packed with carp to over 50 pounds. Our cameras just happened to be there for a few hours during one of its epic sessions.
Daniel!
You can watch the full version of this film in the Jontree 7 venue video out now. Lettier's John London shot a short video on carp care with Duncan DeGrucci. If you're interested in remaining 2013 venue availability at short notice, go to the offers tab on our homepage. Here's a roundup of the month's lake records, starting with a brand new 60 at Golden Oak. Lots of people will know of Jake Watkins through his Michelin star restaurant in Petersfield. Jake's restaurant is also well known for its vast selection of fine wines. But we know Jake because he also happens to be a passionate carp angler. He's just banked the biggest carp yet out of Sapphire at 58 pound 12-ounce mirror. Jake's haul included 350s, 840s and 1430s. Fish is one of Jake's specialities back in his restaurant too. You won't see any carp here, of course. Finally, here's Billy.
Okay, so it's now May, it's May bank holiday weekend, and we've come out to France to basically have a big clear up from all the trees we cut down last time we were here. We brought tree surgeons from England, and that was a bit different because it was snowing, and I was trying to feed all these hungry tree surgeons in the snow and get the trees down. And what we did was just leave a massive mess of, you know, popular logs that round by that high, strewn everywhere along the bank. So we've brought some guys, some friends, and an attachment for our digger, which was a very valuable eBay purchase, which I managed to weld on, and we're moving everything. Yeah, so the ground's a lot drier at last, which is good, because it's just been such a nightmare. Last time we've just ruined all the lawns with the tractor and trailers and things, but finally it's drying out. But we still managed to get stuck coming back from the quick après work beer the other night, and took a shortcut down a lane I know, and managed to get stuck and had to get the tractor out and tow it out, which was fun. So the van's a bit of a mess. And to move all the logs, because in the bottom corner is just quagmire really. We had to build what only can be described as the bridge over the River Kwai. It was a day-long operation and lots of whistling and working. And I just kept whipping them with sticks and things like that, and we got it built. So we're the reason we're trying to clear along the bank is because that's where the infamous ditch hopefully has to be dug. So we've got sort of 10 metres of land and there's logs everywhere, so we've been towing them down with the tractor, which has been really hard work. The attachment I mentioned that we got from eBay, we've welded on. I mean, that is just a mechanical claw that can just lift and move, and you know, saved a lot of work. And we're just clearing in anticipation for the ground to dry out, to have enough room for the 360 digger to spin round. And the reason we're sort of, you know, getting ready is that I've had a phone call from Sue last week, and she's going to come and meet me tonight, going to have a glass of wine, and she said she's got some documents that I need to sign, so fingers crossed. It means that hopefully the planning permission's come through. But in the meantime, I've got what the tree surgeons described as, well, I won't say, but it's my lucky log. And if I'm ever quite concerned, I just give the lucky log a rub. That lives up on the mantelpiece. So woe betide anybody that puts that on the fire.